From Kilburn to Oxford Street, these people announced their madness. They flaunted their insanity. They weren't half mad and half not, curled around a doorframe. They were properly mad, in the Shakespearean sense, talking sense when you least expected it.
Me and Sarah lived parallel lives, like, before we met. We lived in really loud, noisy households that were just always filled with music.
It was sort of, like, instant, really, that we just started writing all these little things together, these little stories. We just got completely addicted and obsessed, and it was the base of our entire friendship, which was originally football. It was that sort of DIY mentality from the beginning that really depicted our journey perfectly.
Where we are in London, I feel like we did have that very community-driven
culture.
Yeah.
Not only is it busy, but we've always been sort of out there, within it and amongst it. Because there's such real characters here and everybody is unapologetic and unashamedly who they want to be. There's nothing around you telling you you're the wacky one, you're the one going too far. And if anything, it just made us want to stretch our limbs even further and push and test our identities even more. Music gave us that gratification that we could do it every day, all day, and just feel amazing. And you could take it to like higher and higher heights, which is definitely how we've ended up as a five-piece, semi-dance, pop, extremely energetic, yeah, visceral live band.
But actually on stage, it's quite a different persona than when we are off stage. Not in a contrived way. I kind of switch off from what's out there and just kind of fall into that world. Kilburn hasn't changed at all. Like, I don't feel like it's allowed itself to change. People are like just so grounded here in the community that it's pretty much the same as it ever was. It's quite amazing that it's kind of managed to hold on to like its identity in that way.